If you wanna buy the cheapest MSP or PSN codes and even games, make sure to check g2a.com discount code OVI. Link is in the description. Hey fellas, how's everyone doing? My name is OVI and welcome to a new FIFA 16 player ratings predictions video. This time we'll change something. I've decided to add a new feature where you can see all the goals, all the assists, the positions where the player has played during the season, and most importantly, his rating in each game of the last season, including his average rating. I've seen a lot of people disagreeing with my previous player ratings, and that's fine. Everyone is free to have his own opinion. What I haven't enjoyed is some people that criticize the ratings I gave without even checking the facts. But this will change. As you will see in each new video, this chart with the players' performances during the past season will make a huge difference. Also wanna thank the website whoscored.com for providing these ratings. So let's jump into our first player, Cesc Fabregas. He's had a winter upgrade and the team of the season card. Besides this, he had an average rating of 7.64, which is very, very good. He scored 5 goals and gave a whopping 21 assists. For this, I see him getting a minimum plus 1 upgrade from an 85 to an 86 overall rating. Moving on to the Chelsea superstar Eden Hazard, he had an inform, a hero card and also team of the season card. And wait for the best part, he's averaged a rating over 8, which is fantastic. For example, Ronaldo averaged 8.3 and Messi an 8.8. Considering this, I believe EA should give him at least a plus 1, if not even a plus 2 upgrade for FIFA 16. Willian averaged a 7.06 rating and had no special card last year, scoring 3 goals, giving 5 assists. Based on this, I do not think EA will upgrade him and they will just keep his current 82 rating. Another offensive player from Chelsea FC who had a decent year is Oscar with a 7.12 rating, scoring 6 goals, giving 8 assists. He had an inform card, but this is just not enough in my opinion for EA to give him an upgrade. I think they will keep his 84 rated card, maybe only with some small adjustments to some attributes. Diego Costa, on the other hand, had a solid year. Even if he didn't score in the UEFA Champions League, he has a total of 20 goals and 4 assists, averaging a 7.28 rating. He received a winter upgrade and he also had a multitude of inform cards, including a team of the season 1. If this doesn't make EA give him an upgrade, I don't know what will. I have him with an 87 card for FIFA 16. Next player on our list is Remy, and this guy didn't have one of his best seasons so far, scoring 9 goals in 25 games, averaging a 6.55 rating. I have him with the same rating or even a small downgrade to 79 for FIFA 16. In contrast with Remy, we have Nemanja Matic with a 7.59 rating, solid performances throughout the year, a winter upgrade and the team of the season card. I think he will get a plus 1 upgrade to an 84 overall rated card. John Terry is like wine, better with age. He had an inform, a man of the match card and 2 team of the season cards. He scored 7 goals and gave 2 assists. I think it's possible EA will boost him from 83 to 84. Another defender with solid performances throughout the last year is Branislav Ivanovic, 7.24 rating, 5 goals, 6 assists, an inform card. EA might give him also plus 1 upgrade. Some other players that I think will keep their ratings from FIFA 15 to FIFA 16 are Cuadrado, Ramirez and Courtois. Even though the Belgian player might get a plus 1 upgrade, not sure about that though. So fellas, what do you think about my predictions and also about the new feature that I added with statistics from the last season for each player? Drop a comment below and let me know. If you've enjoyed the video, leave a like, let's try and smash, let's say 900 likes. Thank you all for watching, my name is OVI and remember, dare to be yourself.